Hello, my name is Kylie, and welcome to Subtracting Negative Numbers. In this video, you will learn how to subtract negative numbers using a number line. Ready to hop around on the number line? Let's go! Before you watch this video, it may be a good idea to have watched our video adding negative numbers. That way, how we use the number line in this video may make better sense. Before we start, let's review how to write negative integers. A negative integer is any number less than zero. Remember, whole numbers or integers are numbers without fractions or decimals. By the way, zero is neutral and is neither positive nor negative. When we write negative numbers, we must always use a negative sign to the left of the number, like this. Both of these show negative 2. When writing negative numbers in math sentences like addition equations, we also use parentheses to make sure we don't confuse a negative number with subtraction. Let's subtract some negative integers. We can use the number line to subtract negative integers very much like using a map to know where we are, where we need to go, and where our destination is when taking a trip. Look at this number line. Okay, it shows us how integers moving to the right increase or go up in value, and how integers moving to the left decrease or go down in value. We will always start at zero. We can use this knowledge to help us subtract negative numbers. Let's get started with this ordinary math subtraction sentence. 6 minus 4. You've probably seen and calculated a lot of math sentences just like this very one. Step one, you start at zero, as always. Step two, count up 6 to the right. Then step three, count down left 4. Because subtracting means move to the left, you land on 2, and that is your answer. 6 minus 4 is 2. Now, get into subtracting negative numbers. Remember one very important idea. Subtracting a number normally means moving to the left on the number line. But when the number that you're subtracting is negative, then the direction changes again, and you end up moving to the right. Some kids find the phrase helpful, minus times minus equals plus. This means if you are dealing with two minus signs next to each other, they cancel each other out and become a plus. This is the same in real-world sentences. You can say, I do not like ice cream. This is just a cumbersome way of saying, I do like ice cream. So the two negatives turn positive again. This is the rule we will use to help us master subtracting negative integers. Here is what I mean by this. Let's start with a positive integer and subtract a negative integer. Here we have 3 minus 7. Subtraction means moving to the left, but here we are subtracting a negative 7. So we end up moving to the right. 3 minus negative 7. Step 1. Rewrite the problem to show adding the positive number instead of subtracting the negative one. Rewrite 3 minus negative 7 as an addition problem. 3 plus 7. Step 2. To solve using a number line, we always start at 0, count up 3, then count up another 7. Of course, you will always add this one in your head. 3 plus 7 equals 10. Step 3. You can then write the original sentence with the correct answer, like this. 3 minus negative 7 equals 10. Here is a subtraction problem with two negative integers. Negative 8 minus negative 3. To calculate or solve this math sentence, use the steps we've learned to subtract negative integers. Step 1. Add the opposite of negative 3 by rewriting the equation as an addition sentence. Negative 8 plus 3. Step 2. Use the number line by starting at 0. Step 3. Count to the left 8 spaces for the negative 8. Step 4. Then add 3 by moving up 3 spaces to the right. You land on negative 5. Negative 8 plus 3 equals negative 5. Step 5. Then you can write the original sentence with the correct answer like this. Negative 8 minus negative 3 equals negative 5. Let's try one more. Negative 7 minus negative 10. Take the original subtraction sentence, rewrite it by changing it to an addition sentence, and changing the sign of the 10 to a positive 10. Remember, we do not need to put a plus sign in front of a positive integer, but it does help. It should look like this. Negative 7 plus 10. Then solve it by using the number line like before. You should end up on the positive 3. I know you're brave and can try 2 on your own. Pause the video and try the following practice problems A and B. When you're ready, press play and I'll share the answer with you. Problem A, 4 minus negative 3. Problem B, negative 5 minus negative 6. How did you do? Did you remember to switch signs and add instead? Here are the answers. Problem A, 4 plus 3 equals 7. Problem B, negative 5 plus positive 6 equals 1. You can always go back and review the steps if you need more help. You've now tackled subtracting negative numbers. I encourage you, if you can, to share your special secret to help others do the same. Now, you will never feel negatively about negative integers. It's always a great idea to keep practicing all your math skills using our fun online games and quizzes. Until next time, always be positively clever. Hey, hey.